It's news time. Information is power. The current, the news headline, how Primate Ayodele prophecy on Nnamdi Kanu coincided with the federal government stand. The 2022 prophecy on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, which was released by Primate Ayodele a few days ago, has coincided with the position of the federal government with regards to the IPOB leader. Recall that the primate Babatunde Elijah Ayodele of Inri Evangelical Spiritual Church issued new divine insights for 2022 on how things will likely turn out for the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB. The revered seer made it clear that Kanu will not be released by the federal government as been expected by many. He went on to say that Kanu should be very, very prayerful, saying that Nnamdi Kanu will not find it so easy as well. She will still expect tough time because the government is not ready to free him for 1 second. He needs to be very careful and prayerful and watchful this time around, and should put that insinuation aside, Sonny Scooter, the man of God, to have said. On the other hand, during President Muhammadu Buhari's interactive section on Channels Television, which was aired on Wednesday, January 5th, 2022, he revealed that the federal government is not planning to release the IPOB leader as his case is already in court of law, and as such, that it is in the discretion of the court to decide on his case. According to Vanguard newspaper, the president was quoted saying that we cannot release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and that his case is for the judiciary, and one of the things that I promised myself is never to interfere with the jobs of the judiciary. I have given him the opportunity to defend himself, and though the president's revelation has continued to generate mixed reactions from Nigerians, but some people have on the other hand hailed the president for being a true Democrat, especially for refusing to interfere in the job of the country's judiciary. They appointed Wali Sani Shiwaram, who happens to be a 45-year-old, as the new leader Wali of the ISWAP in Lake Chad, and the sex membership has swollen with defections of hundreds of Boko Haram fighters under Shekau. Through the Attorney General of the Federation, ought to have done justice to declaring the bandits as terrorists, just as ordered by the court, since they could do so to the indigenous people of Biafra in less than 48 hours. The group stated this in its birthday greetings to the president, who clocks 79 today. The group, led by 86-year-old professor of history, Banji Akintoye, also demanded a referendum to discuss the corporate coexistence of the Nigerian nation. Akintoye's spokesman, Maxwell Adeleye, said that this is the demand of the group to Buhari at 79. He said that we at Ilana Omodua wish President Muhammadu Buhari what he has done for Nigerian people. May his life be run the way he has run Nigeria, and we wish him what he has done for the Yoruba people in Nigeria. On the corporate coexistence of the Nigerian nation, Adeleye said he, Buhari, should allow us conduct a referendum so that we can determine our sovereignty and so that we can determine if we want to remain in Nigeria or not. That is our demand from him at 79. At 79, he is alive because of the grace of God and is enjoying the grace of God. President Muhammadu Buhari is currently in Istanbul, the commercial capital of Turkey, to attend the third Turkey-Africa Partnership Summit hosted by President Recep Tayyip Erdogan of the Republic of Turkey. He, however, got a surprise birthday celebration from his delegation to Istanbul, led by the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Geoffrey Onyema. As he stepped out of his suit moving to the meeting room, President Muhammadu Buhari met a surprise lineup of the Nigerian delegation with a cake decorated in Nigerian's national colors. The group broke into chorus as they began chanting "Happy Birthday, Mr. President." The Minister of Foreign Affairs, who spoke on behalf of the delegation, and the Ambassador of Nigeria to Turkey, Ismail Abba, congratulated the President on the good work he is doing for the country and wished him a happy birthday, saying that many other years ahead and the energy to give him the best to the nation. Also, Senator Seu Sonny had said that coming from Turkey, he should not borrow any cash.
Twitter to wish President Muhammadu Buhari a safe trip to Turkey. The outspoken former senator representing Kaduna Central wished the president a safe trip to and fro. According to Sarah reporters, President Muhammadu Buhari will be traveling to Turkey, and after which he will pay a visit to Ebonyi State, Southeast Nigeria. However, the outspoken senator said He wishes Baba Buhari, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, a safe trip to Turkey and a safe return from Turkey. He also told President Muhammadu Buhari not to borrow from Turkey until we pay what we are owing China and Saudi Arabia. Sarah reporters also gathered that Buhari left the country yesterday, Wednesday, December 15th, 2021, to Turkey. And his words, he says that, "I wish Baba a safe trip to Turkey and a safe return. Please do not borrow any money from them. Make we pay China and Saudi first," in his exactly in his words. And this was because of the enormous borrowing of Nigeria under the administration of President Muhammadu Buhari. Public servant Professor Bolaji Owosonya, who provided the damning evidence of the modus operandi of the official racket in government. Already in the 2022 budget, over 225 projects have been identified as duplications at the cost of 20 billion naira, prompting the House of Rep to set up a probe committee. There is nothing more than appealed to the persuaded Nigerians of his electability and anti-corruption personality. During his first sojourn as military head of state in 1984 to 1986, then General Muhammadu Buhari was seen as the nemesis of corrupt politicians, and that image, which could not help him during previous electoral attempts, was capitalized on by the Southwest media to burnish and garnish a political reputation against an admittedly helplessly ghostless and hapless leadership of Goodluck Jonathan. But history is a mercilessly ruthless judge. While previously clueless and corrupt, Jonathan has become a beautiful bride of international diplomacy and democratic behavior. The anti-corruption warrior is now mired in a government that, by its own reckoning, has become the most inept and corrupt in our history. To be fair, the president did not promise much in the electioneering campaigns in both elections. Throughout the campaigns, his mantra, repeated like a broken record, was fighting corruption, insurgency, and improving the economy. His performance on all three counts is suspect, dubious, and undistinguished. Most people would even declare him a failure. By its own admission, even the government does not point to any of them as its main achievement, which is curious. To it, their greatest achievement is building infrastructure, which was a kind of an afterthought, as it never featured in his 2015 election campaigns. The curiosity is, how could one major in a subject on which he was not tested in an examination? On his greatest failure, agreement will be as difficult to reach. Insecurity has become a major menace in the country, and no part of his nation is spared. But because that is not his greatest failure, nor is the crumbling economy, which he was never given a chance in the first place.
Thanks for listening, and that is the news.